Hi students, welcome back to our IT class. Today we are going to continue our fourth lesson. Shall we start? Activity 4.3. Find the meanings of words. You might have come across various situations where you had to refer to dictionaries to get the meanings of words while learning lessons in English and Hindi. Various online dictionaries in different languages are available at our fingertips in this era of information, communication, technology. Let's know about it. These websites contain the meanings of not only English words but also Malayalam words. This is prepared using the information gathered from various Malayalam dictionaries. It expands constantly with the joint effort of a number of language-loving volunteers across the state. Facilities for translating the meanings of words and sentences to English and Indian languages like Malayalam, Hindi, Tamil, Kannada, Telugu, etc., and to foreign languages are now available on the internet. Can we use these online dictionaries without a computer or an internet connection? Yes, there are solutions to this too in this generation of tablets and smartphones. Offline versions of such dictionaries are now available as mobile apps in mobile phones and tablets. Okay. Next topic, shopping can be done sitting at home. We usually buy rice, vegetables and other things by going to shops. Do you know that these things can be bought without going to shops? There are many commercial sites on the internet. The trade using these commercial sites, that is, the sites on the internet, is called online shopping. We can order the required goods by giving our postal address in these shopping sites. We can pay the cost of the goods by various methods. The goods will be delivered to the given address by post or courier service. Children, do you know this person? He is Winton Cerf, who was the director of ARPANET project, that is the prototype of the internet. He is known as the father of the internet. He played an important role in developing TCP/IP, that is Transmission Control Protocol or Internet Protocol, which is the basic standard for transferring information on the internet. He was born at New Haven in America in the year 1943. Next, we will move to the next topic, copyright and copyleft. Have you heard these words? Let's know it. The information, pictures, movies, sounds, etc. available on the internet are prepared as a result of the effort of different people. There may be some restrictions to use it on our own. Some of them have an exclusive right to the person who developed it based on the copyright law. But some are free for everyone to use. So while we search and use information from the internet, we must be aware whether it is free to use or not. If it is not free, we have to procure permission from the person or institution concerned to use it. We have to be careful while using the internet. While visiting websites, get the correct web address and type it in the browser without mistakes. Sometimes errors may occur while typing the web address. Then you may be led to wrong websites or may be cheated, since there are people who utilize these errors for such purposes. So always make sure that you are typing the correct web address while visiting a website. Okay. While using mobile phones also, we have to be careful. First point, using mobile phone while driving will lead to accidents. If you see someone using it while driving, remain them of this danger. Second point, taking photos and sharing them with an aim to defame persons, that is to insult persons or institutions, are offenses. Remember that taking photos without one's permission is also wrong. Third point, messages which offer gift, lottery, etc. have chances of cyber spoofing. Don't react to such messages. And fourth one, creating false and fake messages which cause defamation to others or stand against national interest or generate rivalry among caste, religion, class is an offense. Storing such message in mobile phones, sharing them, etc. are also offenses. In addition to finding the meanings of words, we can use smartphones for many other day-to-day activities like reading the news, performing banking transactions, finding routes, reserving tickets, finding the bus and train timings, etc. Mobile app are now available to help us. Apps became popular because they are easily available in mobile phones as internet-enabled services. Android Play Store of Google, App Store of Apple, Windows Phone Store of Microsoft, etc. help to install apps easily. At times, you may be worried by some thoughts like, are the electrical equipments at home switched off? Is the valve of the gas cylinder closed? Is the door closed? Etc. Sometimes, you would be relieved only when you check it going back home. Now, electronic equipments at home will observe all these things. They will take care of these things which we have forgotten. Mobile apps and other facilities are available for these purposes. In short, phones or tabs will become multi-purpose devices in the near future. Internet of Things, IoT, means observing and controlling equipments connected to the internet like this. Okay. Our next topic is cyber crimes. Cyber world is a term that generally refers to the use of modern information communication devices like computer, internet, mobile phone, etc. All activities done using the information communication devices like mobile phones, computer, internet, camera, etc., which are against the law or which causes harm or defamation to persons, institutions, technical facilities, etc., are considered as cyber crimes. Role of technology in disaster management. The flood of 2018 is one of the major disasters that Kerala has ever witnessed. Computers can be used for analyzing the data from weather forecasting satellite and radars. We can coordinate the disaster management activities using such data. The information regarding the climatic conditions in different areas is available in the website of the Indian Meteorological Department. It is responsibility of Kerala State Disaster Management Authority, KSDMA, to coordinate the disaster management activities in Kerala. More details are available in the website sdma.kerala.gov.in. Some websites for your information on climatic changes are Indian Meteorological Department, imd.gov.in, Kerala Meteorological Department, imdtvm.gov.in, National Disaster Management Authority, ndma.gov.in. Okay, students, this is the end of this lesson. We will start our fifth chapter in the next class. Thank you for watching.